Hi, my name is Alexis, and I'm a web developer. In this video, I'll show you how to get started with a Wix editor. Now that you have a Wix account, you probably got started with one of Wix's website templates. The next step is to add your own personalized touch. This can mean creating additional elements like images or videos for your website, or more pages for your audience to explore. Whatever your needs may be, the Wix editor is jam-packed with features to help you out. If you need help with the Wix editor, Wix also provides articles like this one, Getting Started with the Wix Editor. If we look at the top left of the Wix Editor, we can see it gives us several options. These are Menus and Pages, which adds new pages and a site navigation menu, Background, which adds a background or edits an existing background, Add, which creates new elements like text buttons and forms, Add Apps, which adds or incorporates an existing app into your site, and the Media section. The Media section allows you to upload media in the form of photos or videos either from your computer or from Google Drive. Next, My Blog, which makes a dedicated blog, and Bookings, which takes online bookings for clients. There are so many options to explore, so we're going to focus on some very common actions. Adding a background, adding a text element, and adding a button for booking. The first thing we'll do is add a background, and backgrounds are extremely important for the overall design and feel of a website. If you're using a template, it should already come with a background. But Wix gives you the freedom to customize your site even more. To add a different background, click on the Background section. This will give us options like Color, which allows us to fill in the background with a solid color, or upload an image or video as a background. If you don't have your own image, Wix also provides a gallery of stock images for you to use. Next, we'll want to add text to the website so people know what our website is all about. Text is one of the most common elements of a website. It gives you a chance to send a message to your audience. We'll click on the Add button and click on Text to add one of the headings. Let's give a title to the website by adding a header of Heading 1. We can also change the appearance of the text by clicking on Edit Text. We can change the size and the font or add extra effects like a drop shadow. Double-clicking the text box allows you to edit the text in the text box, while clicking it once and dragging it lets you position it on the page. Let's say we're making a website for a personal chef service, so we'll change the heading's text. We can change the text in the text box by double-clicking on it, and then we can take one of the corners of the text box and click and drag that to change the dimensions of the text box. Next, let's add one more text box to add a description of the website. This time, let's choose a paragraph. A few changes later, and we're ready to add the last touch to our website. We can also add a button that allows us to book a chef. Click on the Add section, then choose one of the buttons. You can click and drag a button just like a text box to change its dimensions. Clicking on a button will also allow us to change the placeholder text. In our case, we want our button to say, "Book a chef now." After a few more changes to the positioning of the elements of our website, we can take a look at our website in preview mode. To do that, click on the Preview button in the upper right-hand corner of the editor. This is our finished website. When you're happy with what you have, you can finally publish it and make it live on the internet. Click on the Publish button in the upper right-hand corner and you'll get a URL for your published website. Clicking on the View Site button will open a tab in your browser with your live website. To wrap up, we learned the Wix editor has several sections to choose from to help us build a website. Menu and Pages, Background, Add, Add Apps, Media, My Blog, and Bookings. We then learned how to add a background to a website, how to add an edit text, and how to add a button for bookings. Lastly, we learned how to preview a website before putting it live on the internet, then publish it with the Publish button to share it. So great work, you now know everything you need to know to get started with Wix.